All right, this should be good. Now it is the right landscape orientation, and people will start streaming in. All righty, here we go. Live show number 3, everybody. Adam Beiter, hashtag songs of comfort. Just keeping people entertained while in coronavirus lockdown. I got a bunch of great songs for tonight, so I hope a lot of people get the chance to watch, and even if you don't right now, you can always go back to the start and start watching then. So I learned my lesson from last time, and I'm not going to spend a whole lot of time just waiting for people to arrive. I'm just going to start with my first song. Tomorrow's Earth Day, and I feel like this song's very relevant to Earth Day. It's a little bit ahead of its time. It was released in 1988, one of Bruce Hornsby's greatest older songs. And it's all about environmentalism and pollution and, you know, taking care of the earth, being aware of what's going on around you especially. It's kind of the whole point of the song, so I hope you guys really like this one. Here we go. Guys, looks like there's 8 people watching. That's really good. Thank you guys so much. That's amazing. Thank you for watching. Sorry about all the technical difficulties that initiated at the start of this. It's did not know what my phone was doing, but I got it figured out. So we're all good. Alrighty, that's fantastic. So
I'm going to actually start with two covers this time. I forgot to mention, I'm actually wearing a shirt from the guy who did that song, Bruce Hornsby. He does this great duo with this bluegrass mandolin player, Ricky Skaggs. And I've seen him in concert once together, as well as I've seen Bruce Hornsby solo many times. So the next one's a cover from somebody whose shirt I wore last time. I'm trying to switch up the music shirts a lot. Maybe I'll do my Bob Dylan shirt next time. Challenging myself to memorize that whole song. I was nervous, actually. I wasn't sure if I was going to be able to do it, because, you know, it's a lot of the same. Really, the trick to memorizing that song is memorizing the first thing of every stanza, because once you have that, the rest kind of comes naturally, because you've listened to the song and you, like, know what comes after that one, but, like, you don't know which one to sing whenever you go to the start of the stanza. So I'm like, what's the start of the song? Oh, Harry Truman! And then I know the rest of the whole song, so. Now I'm going to do an original. It's called Motion and Light. there are so many people who sad the dogs. Think about the life, think about the rocks, think about the force and beauty of the realm. The forces. The forces against. The forces against. And bolts us to the ground.
When I look into your eyes, I don't know why.
It's not the Rent song.
No, that'd be a good one.
Yeah.
This one's unique because usually when I write songs, I write them by myself, like both music and lyrics. But this one, I actually was collaborating with my friend Peyton. He wrote the lyrics, and I asked for permission to do this. I was like, "Are you okay with me doing this?" And he was like, "Yeah, let's do it." So, this is kind of got a little bit of political message. It's about America's homeless problem. Really, like people being out of jobs, out of places to live. Like they're having a really hard time, especially during this pandemic. So this is, it's called All American Rat. That's his title. That's pretty good. It's one of those songs that doesn't actually have the title in the lyrics. I was born on the city streets, not a place to call my own. Dirty, mangy, and abused, I was trying to find a home. By the Indigo Girls. They're releasing a new album in May, but this is not one of their best known, but it's one of their best well-made, their most well-made. It's called All That We Let In. It's a beautiful title too, and it came out only a couple months after I was born, and it was one of the first albums that I listened to, even though I was like 6 months old maybe when I listened to it for the first time. But it's always been really, it's pretty much what inspired my love of music, as well as a bunch of other things. So this is one of the best songs. It's called Perfect World, and it is very relevant today.
You get to be a ripple in the water. You get to be a rock that's thrown.
The element of an instrumental piece from last. I did two my first show and then none my second show, so I'm gonna do one this show, kind of balance it out, so that there's an average of one per show. But this isn't one that I wrote. This is probably
0.9 of a person. Sorry,
it's okay. Okay, this is probably a lot of you recognize this, especially if you've watch. Oh, there was a great one that was just on the Easter Beagle, Charlie Brown. It's one of the funniest ones, in my opinion. It's really, it just had me in hysterics. It's amazing how it can really speak to people of all ages. It's just that funny. So here we go. Here's Linus and Lucy. Change, because that was a little bit of an exercise on the fingers. I'm not actually going to play the piano for this one. I'm going to play myself. I have a pre-made recording of a classic a cappella song. It's three. Yeah, I got to do that. Thank you for reminding me. Wow.
Gentle. We need to move the camera.
I'm fine. Here, I'll just put it down here. I timed it out so that I can get back to the mic as soon as I can. And we're at a good volume setting. All right, let's see how this goes.
Whoa, for the longest time. Whoa, for the longest time.
If you said goodbye to me tonight, there would still be music left to write. What else could I'm so inspired by you. That hasn't happened for the longest time. Once I thought my innocence was gone. Thank you. Now I know that happiness goes on. That's where you found me. When you put your arms around me, I haven't been there for the longest time. Maybe won't last very long, but if you feel so right, then I could be wrong. Maybe I've been hoping too hard, but we've come this far, and it's more than I hoped for. I'm that voice you're hearing in the hall, and the greatest miracle of all is how I need you, and how you needed me too. That hasn't happened for the longest time. Who knows how much further we'll go on. Maybe I'll be sorry when you're gone. I'll take my chances. I forgot how nice romance is. I haven't been there for the longest time. I had second thoughts at the start. I said to myself, hold on to your heart. Now I know the woman that you are. You're wonderful so far, and it's more than I hoped for. I don't care what consequence it brings. I have been a fool for lesser things. I want you so bad. I think you ought to know that I intend to hold you for the longest time. Whoa.
That's a cool experiment. Just a shout out to it's not the only little acapella venture I've been having with the HHS Jazz Club. With the HHS, with the Hamburg High School Jazz Choir, we put together, and I have to thank my friend Emma Lutz for that, and really everybody else in the jazz club. But she put together a video of us doing this great Anders Edenroth jazz acapella piece called Words. And it's just really great. I think it's on my timeline if you want to see it. But yeah, that was kind of, I've been having a lot of those cool multi-track experiences where you can make music with other people and with yourself, even during times of quarantine. Next song, I just, had to, actually, do I want to do this one? Yeah, I do. Okay. This is actually a Throwback Thursday kind of thing, except it's Tuesday. I wrote this probably, when did I write this? Probably sixth grade, so I was like 11, 2014, that time frame. I remember I performed it for my family at our Ellicottville getaway in 2015, so yeah, it's at least 5 years old. One of my oldest actual good songs, probably. So, the working title for this back when I used to perform it a lot was Gravity Impulse, so that's just what I'll call it now. Easier to do that than you.
just keep it fresh and free. It's easier to do that than it may seem. Wouldn't you like to go with me to the end of the world? Yeah. Wouldn't you like to go with me to the end of the world? Yeah. Wouldn't you like to go with me to the end of the world? Yeah. Wouldn't you like to go with me to the end of the world?
That's what you said when I first wrote it.
Yeah.
Next is another cover. Tragically Hip, great band. It's one of their most popular songs. I've been doing more obscure songs by them, but this is actually one of their most popular songs.
What is it?
Bobcaygeon.
Oh, okay.
Did you know when Noah heard this, he thought it was some John Cage? Well, he thought it was about John Cage.
Ah, yeah, because he doesn't talk about
it. There's the other John Cage song.
Yep.
That's by the Trash Play. Do 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 a repeat from the first set list. I don't mind. I think there are some that are that have become fan favorites. Am I mistaken?
read your book, I've read it over, page to page and cover to cover. It took me a while, but finally I can tell you what I think of it and what it thinks of me. I've read your book, I've read a lot, each character and all their lives, each shade and both, the time and the place, how it relates to modern society and the human race. Take it everything in over the beginning. It's not the way I wanna do this, chasing after your story. It's not the way I wanna do this, I'm seeing a thing, I wanna be strong.
For this one, although I did not have to for Weed Instead of Fire, that's weird. Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again because a vision softly creeping left its seeds while I was sleeping.
The Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again. Because a vision softly creeping left its seeds while I was sleeping. And the vision that was planted in my stories within the sound of silence.
Thanks to our daily Simon and Garfunkel.
What? Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Another repeat that I think is a fan favorite.
You're on.
Two more songs of the night, and then I'm going to be done. It'll probably be about an hour. This one's a bit different, by a band called Fish. It's actually one of their most recent releases from 2016. It's great, really, kind of an inspiring song, you know, like a pep talk. It's really cool. You'll like it. Life in slow motion, feet are in the clay. I'm going nowhere, been standing here all day. I've had a notion there was something more to do. As I watch the water from the banks of the river, I swell the root and I tip to the left, lean to the right, tip to the left, lean to the right. Walked on cold and slapped on glass amid swords of sound and daggers of light. And my heart is screaming. Cause half of what I say is lies, and it takes so much to keep up this disguise.
If you want to make requests for the my next bi-weekly, or I really should say, my next 2 weeks, in a fortnight's time, I'll be doing another show. So if you want to, if you want anything played, specific or just general like pop tunes, Broadway tunes, that sort of stuff, just leave your request in the comments. Thanks, everybody. It was great to have you here. All right, here we go. It's got a message that I love. I think it's very valuable in today's time. Here we go.
Tune in next fortnight.
All right.